Hey everybody, it's Robert with a video today all about carpet. I'm going to be giving you guys a quick crash course on the most essential elements of selecting a product for your home so that you can confidently go out and start shopping for carpet and have the best opportunity to get something that's going to really perform the way that you want it to long term. For those of you that are new to my channel, my name's Robert. I've worked in the flooring and remodeling industry for about 15 years. So if you're looking for a guide to help answer some of the questions regarding your next project, definitely subscribe below and follow along for more videos in the future. Before we jump into today's, be sure to hit that like button. And after we're all said and done, comment down below with any of your thoughts, questions that you might have regarding what I talked about in today's video, or anything you'd like to see any videos on in the future. When it comes to carpet, I find that most of my clients that come into the store that have been disappointed with carpet in the past were misled by somebody either not providing them the right information or missing information when they made that selection process. Or they inherited carpet from somebody that they bought the house from and they didn't have the right product for that environment. So today's video is all about the key elements in terms of performance and making sure that you get a carpet that's going to do what you need it to for your home specifically. I'm not here to endorse any particular brand. I'm not here to endorse any particular style or color selections. We can certainly go over that in another video, but today's video, I want to make sure that you have the essential understanding of what drives how well a carpet's going to perform for your home. The number one most important element of how a carpet will perform for you is what it is made of. Above things like ounce weight, twist level, the particular construction of it, whether or not it's cut or it's looped, what it's made of is going to drive the performance first and foremost above all else. So we have three fiber types that are going to make the vast majority of the product selections out there for you guys. So the first fiber type, guys, is nylon. And to highlight the key things you should know about nylon, it's a very durable fiber. It's not as naturally stain resistant as some of the other options. That's why it needs to be treated with something, which is where names like Stainmaster come into play. These are different coatings that they put on the nylon to help protect it from staining. I'm not going to go too much into the physics or chemistry elements of how those products are applied or some of the treatments that they put on them, but that's the quick thing that you need to know. Durable, not the most naturally stain resistant. Nylon is also a more expensive raw material, so nylons generally are going to run a little bit higher than our other synthetic options we're going to talk about today. And the second fiber type is polyester. Polyester is almost the flip side of nylon. It's not as naturally durable. It's not going to hold up as well against foot traffic as what a nylon will, but it is more naturally stain resistant. So food and beverages generally will come out of polyester easier than they'll come out of nylon, all other factors the same. Polyester also is a less expensive raw material. So we can get heavier ounce weight carpets with polyester for less expensive than the equivalent in a nylon. And the last fiber type is the smart strand fiber, which is technically called Triexta. And that was a fiber invented back in about 2005 by Mohawk. Mohawk has that product exclusively, as well as a couple companies that they own, namely Karastan, and also a predominantly wool company called Godfrey Hirst, which will also have a few smart strand products in it. But you're most likely to see this in either the Mohawk or its kind of luxury line, Karastan. Now, the Triexta fiber is going to basically merge the two benefits that we talked about with nylon and polyester. It's a very durable fiber, but it's also inherently stain resistant. So there is no treatment to make it more stain resistant. The fiber itself naturally resists stains. This is a product I have in my own personal home, and if you haven't guessed just by the way I've been talking about it, it is my personal preference. I think it's the most advanced technology in carpet. Smart strand carpet, I find to be the easiest carpet to clean with just strictly hot water. It's also inherently bleach resistant, so you can pour undiluted bleach into the fiber and it will not discolor it. A nylon, if you were to pour bleach into, you will bleach the color out. Just a fun fact for you on the side. Now, I mentioned the ounce weight, and simply put, ounce weight is a measure of how much yarn is in 1 square yard of that carpet. So if we take a 3 foot by 3 foot section of carpet and we actually measure the amount of the yarn that was used in that, that is our ounce weight. So a 60 ounce is exactly that. There's 60 ounces of that yarn in 1 square yard. Now, a 30 ounce nylon is still going to be more durable than a 40 ounce polyester. because the material itself is more naturally durable. And this is where I find a lot of people get misled. They think that the more material, the more durable it's gonna be. For this reason, I actually don't spend a lot of time talking with people about the ounce weight because I don't want them to get hung up on something in terms of how it will perform based off of how much yarn there is. And a lot of manufacturers actually don't list the ounce weights on their products for that same reason. All right, so just like I mentioned that ounce weight isn't going to necessarily impact how durable the product is, I also want to show you another misconception regarding how well a product will perform, and that's the construction type of it, the particular style of carpet. So here I've got a looped Berber type carpet, and I've got a textured plush, almost a frise style carpet. Now, I have a lot of people that would inherently think that because this one's looped, it's going to be more naturally durable than this product. But again, if we're comparing a looped polyester with a cut pile nylon, my nylon is going to be more durable, again, because of the fiber type. So we can manipulate the ounce weight and the construction elements, but the fiber type still overrules the construction in terms of how it will perform. Now, if I have a nylon and a nylon, and this is the Berber, well, because it's a lower pile, as it starts to wear, you may not notice some of the wear patterns as quickly as on the cut pile. But all other factors being the same, if they're both nylons, they are gonna perform relatively similarly. Another thing I see people come in and do is they'll grab a carpet and they'll try and separate it with their two fingers to see if they can find the backing of it and think that if they can, it's not gonna be as durable of a carpet. But you have different styles of carpet and some naturally will allow you to see the backing easier than others. A tight plush construction, you're gonna have a harder time separating that and seeing the backing than you are on a loose cabled frise carpet. But what that carpet's made of is still gonna be the more important element of how it's going to perform. All right, and then to talk about the last key factor in selecting your carpet that is important, but it is not more important than the carpet itself, is gonna be your pad selection. So when it comes to pad, again, trying to keep this relatively simple and straightforward for you guys, there's gonna be a couple things to consider with your cushion. You're gonna see that there's a couple different measurements involved with cushion, one of which is the thickness, which is literally just how thick that cushion is. The other is the density, which is going to be a measurement of the pounds per yard of that cushion. So if we look at this particular cushion, this is what we call a 7/16 inch thick, 6 pound density cushion. And this is what I would largely consider to be kind of the standard for cushion. It's not the absolute base grade that you'll find out there in some of the options. It's also not in any way what I would consider an upgraded pad. I would consider this very much a middle of the road type of cushion. There's also versions of this that are more designed specifically for looped carpets that are slightly denser and slightly thinner. And that would kind of be the standard for that particular type of carpet. But for most of your products, this is going to be kind of your basic standard cushion. Now moving into more of an upgraded cushion, we're going to typically be looking at something that's an 8 pound density and half inch thick. It could still be construction of a variety of cushion scraps that have been rebonded together. And when they say rebonded, that's what they mean. But it could be a variety of different cushions, or it may be a product that's 100% memory foam, but is still created through the scraps being bonded together like that. The other thing we're gonna see on our typical upgraded cushions is going to be a moisture protectant on the surface of it. So where the backside is just strictly the cushion scraps, you can see the front side, we have a spill guard so that if anything gets into your carpet, it stops at your pad. This makes it easier to clean it the first time because it hasn't gotten down into the subfloor and started to pool out. That's a huge benefit, and I consider to be probably the biggest benefit to moving into an upgraded cushion in terms of how it's gonna affect the day-to-day performance of it. But the increased density also makes it a little bit more comfortable underfoot. And then moving into something that I would consider to be more of a premium grade cushion, we're still gonna be looking at products that are largely 8 pounds, half inch thick, still have a moisture barrier on them, but we're gonna be moving away from a rebonded construction to more of a pure foam construction. This particular one here is pure memory foam. And the biggest benefit that these are gonna give you is additional comfort underfoot, a little bit longer durability in the performance of it. And a lot of these cushions will actually increase the warranties of the carpets. Now again, this in and of itself is not going to make a carpet do something that it's not designed to do. It's not going to make a polyester inherently more durable. It's not going to make a nylon inherently more stain resistant, but it is something that helps a carpet be the most that it can be for what it already is. Hopefully that makes sense. So with all these things in mind, how would I make a recommendation as to which type of product you should get? Really comes down to where you're going to put it and what your long-term intentions are. If we're talking about a product that we're going to live in ourselves and we want a lot of durability out of it for the long term, then we're going to probably want to look at either a nylon or the smart strand fiber. For areas that are high traffic, like stairs, I would generally never recommend doing a polyester product for something that I'm going to live on for a long period of time. It's just not as durable. In areas like your master bedroom, you're going to see that traffic wear lane as you enter the room into the bathroom faster on a polyester than we would on our other two fiber types. Now let's say that we're going to get ready to sell this house and we just need something that's, you know, really comfortable, presents well to a new buyer, then I might look at polyester as my absolute best option. And that's generally what I recommend for clients, because you can get the most bang for your buck with that type of product. You can get a lot of ounce weight. It's very comfortable underfoot. It presents really well, but you're not as concerned personally with the long-term performance of it because you're not going to be the one to live there. And a lot of buyers are going to be looking at it and say, well, this isn't the color I like. So they may be able to get a few good years out of that product, but then they have their own intentions of changing it to something else down the road anyways. Also, if I'm looking at a guest bedroom or a kid's bedroom and I just want to get as much comfort out of it as possible, but I only have maybe one person that's living in there on a daily basis, or it's a guest room, then this is, again, another ideal environment for me to use a polyester carpet, because I could pay a little bit less and I can get more yarn to it. I can get a little bit more comfort out of it, but I'm not as concerned with how much it's going to wear because it doesn't get as much traffic. If I'm really concerned with stains and soiling, then I'm going to be much more likely to go with the smart strand fiber than I am going to go with a nylon. Because even though I'm going to get a lot of durability out of my nylon, I know that the smart strand fiber is much more inherently easy to clean and much more stain resistant. So kids, pets, I'm going to be better set up for success with the smart strand fiber than I am going to be with a nylon. Now, nylon I generally recommend for people that have had nylon before and loved it. Why mess with success? If I have somebody that's, you know, lived on nylon for many years and that's what they're comfortable with, then we know it's tried and true and it's very durable. Are there more advanced technologies? Absolutely. But if you don't have the kids, you don't have the pets, and you just want something that's, you know, gonna wear like iron for you, and you like the particular style that you found, then nylon's a great product. It's just not as easy to naturally clean. So again, gauge that based on what exactly it is you're exposing your carpet to in your household. So there's your crash course on carpet, guys, regarding the key elements of selecting a product that's gonna perform well for you in your house. From there, you can start to focus on all the fun parts like style, color, pattern, but it's really a shame if you find something that seems to be the perfect design fit for your home, and then a year from now, you're just devastated and disappointed with how it's actually performed for you. If you have any additional questions on the carpet, definitely hit the comments down below and let me know what I can be a little bit more specific on. I'll answer those questions either in the comments, or if there's enough to go into detail on for another video, I'll be sure to make a future video on it. I do love getting into all the design, style, color elements of it as well, but I find that that needs to be a secondary conversation after making sure that we're putting the right type of carpet in for the long-term performance of your home. I really appreciate you guys watching this video today. If you found it helpful, please hit that thumbs up button, comment down below, and subscribe to see more videos from me in the future. Until next time, happy remodeling and have a great day.